Hey everybody, welcome to Looking at the Markets. This is a pretty cool picture here. Can you see it? It's a bunch of random movements. It's a dot moving all over the place just randomly. It's pretty cool. I got this off of Wikipedia. If you go to Wikipedia and type in Brownian motion, which is what we're going to be talking about today, and randomness, the randomness in science and math and the randomness in the stock market. It's a pretty cool page. You might want to check it out. Just type Brownian motion into Wikipedia. Here's another one. Check that out. Look at all those dots moving all over the place randomly. That's called Brownian motion. It's a good term to know. Want to see another one? Here we go. That's all right off of the Wikipedia page. Look at that. Bouncing all off of each other. There's no way to predict the movements of all those little dots. They just go wherever they go. So let's talk about Brownian motion and how it applies and how it can make you a better stock trader and investor. Not just stocks, options, cryptocurrencies, Forex, commodities, whatever it is. It all applies. So what is this Brownian motion? It refers to either the physical phenomenon that minute little particles immersed in a fluid move around randomly, like those pictures we just saw. Or for math people, it's the mathematical models used to describe those random movements. So it's in science, it's in math. Brownian motion was discovered by the biologist Robert Brown way back in 1827. And while Brown was studying pollen particles floating in water under a microscope, he observed those little minute particles in the pollen grains executing a jittery random motion. Kind of like, maybe like this, right? Or maybe more like this or like this, whatever it is. And for you math people out there, if you'd like to see the geometric Brownian motion, the formula, there it is. It's okay if you don't understand it, that's fine. You don't have to. But there it is if you're into that, or you can just Google it. The mathematical theory of Brownian motion has been applied in contexts ranging far beyond the movement of particles in fluids. Mathematicians generally agree that stock markets, the foreign exchange markets, commodity markets, and bond markets follow Brownian motion, where assets are changing continually over very small intervals of time, and the asset prices are being altered by random amounts. In other words, they're constantly moving small amounts pretty much randomly. Now, let me give you my thoughts on that really quickly. Is it really random stock price movements? I guess if somebody was God-like and they could know everything that was going on in every investor's brain, and they could know every political situation going on, and they could know what every sentiment, every thought, everything that was, all the factors, maybe it's not random to somebody who's omniscient and all-knowing, theoretically speaking. But for us humans, since we cannot know everything that's going on, then it is random to us. I think it's relatively random, even if it's not absolutely random. That's how I feel about it. So as far as we're concerned, for all intents and practical purposes, since we're not omniscient, it is pretty random, I think, at least in the short term. And that's what they're talking about. With Brownian motion, they're talking about the very small, very short-term moves. The options market generally agrees on this as well. That's why options prices, which are calculated using the Black-Scholes model, you can Google that, the Black-Scholes model includes geometric Brownian motion. In other words, option prices factor in a certain amount of randomness. In other words, a lack of knowing where stock prices will go in the future. All right. So options, the options market knows this. They know that the short-term movements in the future are random, pretty much. So, and yeah, in other words, option prices factor in a certain amount of that randomness. To put it another way, both mathematicians and the options market agree that people cannot predict the direction of the market or an individual stock. They know that. But beginners in the stock market or options market, cryptocurrency markets, and so on, don't usually know this. Beginners tend to think that there is someone out there who can predict where a stock, option, cryptocurrency, whatever, is going to go in the short term. Whether it's a minute from now, an hour from now, tomorrow, next week, whatever. All right, so I want you to get out of that beginner mindset if you're in it right now. If you think there's somebody out there who knows where a stock is going to go or a cryptocurrency, currency pair, commodity, whatever. If you believe that there's somebody out there that knows where it's going to go in the very short term, in the next hour or day, or even week for that matter, I would recommend that you go back and study Brownian motion. Really look at those dots and understand that mathematicians know it. Seasoned traders and investors know it, most of them, I hope. The options market knows it, and the options market is very sophisticated, and they have a lot more resources and data than you and I do. So think about Brownian motion, think about randomness, understand it. And that doesn't mean that it's all random. Over the long term, the S&P 500, for example, has a tendency to go upwards over time. So that's why I say in the short term, it's random. Over the long term, did you know that if you had bought the S&P 500 stocks at any point in history of the stock market in the US, 20 years later, you would have made a profit. Okay, so no matter when you bought it, even at the worst possible time, right before a crash. So over the long term, yes, it goes up. So it's not completely random, otherwise it wouldn't predictably go up over any 20-year period that you choose. So the stock market, I believe, it has randomness in the short term, but an upward bent or an upward tendency over the long term. It's random with an upward skew, if you will. But as far as trying to predict in the next hour what's going to happen, in the next minute, in the next day, forget it. And I'm not going to try to sell you that, and I'm not interested in somebody trying to sell me that. All right, hope I gave you something deep to think about. Some deep thoughts here. Brownian motion. Check it out. Google it. You'll be glad you did it. If you want some help with any of this stuff, putting together a trading or investing plan, you can contact me. Email davidmodell@gmail.com. If you like this video, if it made you think, go ahead and leave a comment. Give it a thumbs up on the video there, and feel free to subscribe. I'd really appreciate it if you did that. Thanks a lot. I'll talk to you again soon.